Join us for this episode of the DevOps Lab. You don't want to miss this. Join myself and Nikita as we walk you through Azure load testing as it's now generally available. So tune in. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the DevOps Lab. We have a very, very exciting episode for you this time, and I'm inviting back a returning guest. Nikita, welcome back to the DevOps Lab.
Hi, April. Thanks for having me on this episode.
I'm really excited to have you back. Last year, you came to us and you told us all about Azure load testing when it was in preview, but you have some really exciting news for us.
Yes, Azure load testing is now generally available. So customers can use it for load testing their applications. Azure load testing, as you know, is a fully managed load testing service, which helps you generate high scale load. So developers and testers can use it to test their application and identify if there are any bottlenecks and make it more performant.
Absolutely. And so many customers get their applications to the cloud and they want to optimize them. So this is a great tool to invest in that's fully managed. I'm really excited to see the new features. So can you go ahead, take it away and show us what some of the new features are coming out in GA?
Yeah, definitely. So we've launched a bunch of features ever since we have launched from public preview till now. And I'll show you a few of them, which are really some of the most loved features and most requested features from our customers.
Awesome.
Let's start with just getting started with Azure load testing, right? It's really easy. And today I'll take you through testing a .NET podcast app. So this is a podcast website where you can search for podcasts, you can listen to podcasts. So we are going to load test this this application today. So let's just get started. So you have two options to get started. The really quick one way is to start testing with a quick test. A quick test just requires you to just enter a URL and there you're done. You can just configure how much load you want to test for. So I'll say 50 virtual users. What is the duration you want to test for? Do you want the load to ramp up in certain duration? So if I say it ramps up in say 20 seconds and just say run. And there you go. The test is created and the test would start running immediately.
Awesome. So that's really the test started with some really easy metrics on a website URL.
Yes. So you don't need to know any knowledge of any prior testing tools. You can just get started with the URL and you can just look at what are the features of the product, and you can see if this really is helping you to load test your application. While this is a very good way to get started, you can just unlock the entire potential of the service when you use a JMeter script. So as you can see, there's an option where you can upload a JMeter script. Now, JMeter is a very highly used open source load testing tool and it's very popular in the community. So we've seen that customers use a lot of JMeter and they are using it in all different ways, right? And today I'll show you how you can use a JMeter script and really unlock the potential of Azure load testing service by doing that. So,
awesome.
So you can just say create, and I'll just give a name to my test and get started. So let's call it my podcast test. And here I have to upload a test plan. So a test plan is your JMeter script. Now let me show you what my JMeter script looks like. As you can see here, I have configured my JMeter script to load test the podcast application. I have added samplers for testing a podcast page, the home page, the discover page, and the search page. So I have all of these four pages that I am load testing. I also have a CSV input data file that I'm providing as a CSV input for the search and the podcast page. So I'm giving parameters from the CSV input file, and this you can do very easily by just providing the file name and your variable names. And I'm also using custom functionality. Now, custom functionality is where you can extend the core functionality of JMeter by writing some custom code. So as you can see here, I'm using a custom function here. It's a simple function which just grabs the environment variable. So I'm using that as well. Now you can use all of this using Azure Load Testing, and you can use these components while you are testing in Azure Load Testing. So you can just upload all the files that you have. As you can see, I have my JMeter script, I have my jar file. Now this is the jar file which is required for me to use the custom function that I showed you. And then there's a shows.csv, which is basically my CSV input data. So I select all of these and I say upload. And that's it. You can just run the test if you want from here. But I also have an option where I can split the CSV evenly between test engines. Now, this really helps when you don't want same data to be used across the different test engines that you're going to use in your test. For example, if you're using a login scenario and you don't want the same credentials to be used on every test engine, so you can always split the CSV between different test engines, and each test engine picks up unique rows of the CSV. So let me just select this and we'll go to the next tab. So here, like you saw, there's a function where I say to grab my environment variable. So I'll just give my environment variable, which is actually the URL of the app that I want to test. Let me just enter. So for this, we are going to test a URL which is actually not publicly accessible. Let me just show you. So this is the website that we are testing. You can see that this is for showing me a 403 forbidden error because I have put access restrictions on this, as it can be cannot be accessed from a public internet. So it can be only accessed from a virtual network. So I'll show you how you can actually test a private endpoint here. So testing a public endpoint is very straightforward, but when you want to test a private endpoint, you can also do that using Azure Load Testing. So this is a private endpoint, I've given the value of the web app URL here. This web app that you've seen is also configured to have secure authentication. So we have configured a client certificate on this, and so you can also provide that here. So I'll just enter my certificate, which is in a key vault. So you can, as you can see, you can enter a key vault reference identifier here. So I just give the key vault URL here, which points to my certificate, and Azure Load Testing would grab that certificate from the key vault and use it while it is sending a request to your application. So this is my parameters. Coming to load, now I can select how much load I want to simulate on my application. So here I select five engines. So basically my JMeter script runs on each of these five engines. So my load, whatever I've configured in my load test plan, is multiplied by five. And these are the different engines which would simulate the load on my application. Now, when you come to load, I remember when I said that it is a private endpoint and not a public, I can configure the network here. So as you can see, I have two options. One is public and one is private. Since this is a private endpoint, I'll select a private option, and then I can just select my VNET from where I can load test this. So this application that I showed you is accessible from this demo podcast VNet. So I select the demo podcast VNet, and it is configured to be accessible from the default subnet. So I just have to select the virtual network and the subnet, and I'm good to go. It's as simple as that.
And what I really like is we talk to customers a lot about protecting production, right? We don't want to just always test production, but when we're pushing our code to our dev test environments or pre-prod, this enables us to do that securely, not expose ourselves, and segment out those other environments so we're not hurting or going against production, right?
Exactly. Yeah. So you can keep your endpoint secure, you can keep it private, and still you can load test using this private VNet injection feature that we have.
Awesome. That we have so many customers that ask for that, to get the privatized VNet injection, because, you know, I think there was a time in Azure when everything was publicly available and that's your exposure risk. So being able to keep everything kind of in that private VNet, restrict the access, plus access our certificates from Key Vault, that really enables us to segment out our environments really well.
Yeah. Moving forward, the next configuration is test criteria. So this is basically, you can define some criteria and specify what is your expectation of the system that you're testing. And here now we've added a new feature, which is called requesting, where you can enter and define your test criteria at the request level. So as you saw, I had four requests in my JMeter script, and I can say response time for, say, 90th percentile, it shouldn't be greater than, say, I'm saying 5 seconds for the podcast page, right? So I can just enter the name of the request, and it just makes sure that it's calculating the response time just for the podcast page. I can also do aggregate level metrics where, since I want to load test the overall application, I can say, for example, error rate, the percentage of error shouldn't be greater than, say, 10%. And then this is calculated at the aggregate level. So you can define multiple test criteria on multiple metrics. As you can see, you have error, mm-hmm. you have requests, you have latency, you have the throughput, and you have response time. And then each of these are available on different aggregate functions. You have average, minimum, maximum, all the percentiles that you want to configure, you can do.
So those percentiles as well for response time align to maybe what our SLAs are for application that we're delivering to our end users. So that's really, really helpful. Yes. I like that. That's cool.
Yes. And this also allows you to know what is the status of this criteria at the end of the test. And then you can decide if you want to take some action in case these fail. Mm-hmm. Going forward, you can also configure monitoring, where you can monitor the resource and look at the server-side metrics of your application. Say, for example, I'm looking at my demo podcast. So I can just say demo podcast, and I can select my web app. I have a storage account as well, and I have a SQL database. So I'm just selecting these, and these get added as application components. And when my test runs, I can actually see the metrics from Azure Monitor for each of these application components, which come up in my dashboard.
That's really helpful. That's really helpful to get the monitoring feedback, because we talk so much about that in the process of application development. To get that monitoring, get that feedback, and hook that into Azure Monitor is really powerful. So you get that immediate feedback, especially during the load test.
Yes. It also helps you identify if there's anything going wrong and where exactly that's going wrong, right?
And through the full stack, which is really, really helpful, because it might not be your application, but maybe connection to the database or a problem there as well.
Yeah. Awesome. So we are done creating the test. I've configured everything. I've configured all my files. I've configured the load, the resources. So we can just hit on create, and my podcast test is being created, right? So while this test creates and starts running, I can just take you through an existing test which I've run earlier, and I'll take you through how the results look like. Yeah, mm-hmm. So this has started already, but I can take you through an existing test as well.
Perfect.
So this is a test run, exactly the same thing that I've configured just now, that I ran some time back. As you can see, this test run gives me all the statistics of what were the response time, what was the error percentage, what was my throughput for my application here, right? It also gives me what were my test criteria and what was the result. As you can see, both of these passed. So the result for this test is passed. I also see the client-side metrics here. The client-side metrics show me what was the load, how the load ramped up, and then the load was constant, and then the load ramped down for each of these requests that I have. And then I see the response time here. As you can see, at one point, the response time really shot up, and mm-hmm. then it stabilized and it became constant later. So we can see why exactly that had happened. We can look at the server-side metrics and maybe try to identify what happened. I also see at one point the error. So as soon as the error started coming, you can see that so you can correlate what happened during the test, right? Mm-hmm. And the server-side metrics also help me in that correlation. As you can see, I see the different metrics for all the app components that I had configured. And most of these look pretty good, but I can see the CPU, memory, everything is under control. But I see maybe my SQL quickly shot up to 100% and went beyond, right? So there could be some bottleneck in the SQL DB, which maybe I can look into and further dig deeper and see if there's some scaling up that I can do and maybe improve the performance of the SQL DB, right? Mm-hmm. So so you get a complete view of the entire test and see end to end what had happened when your application was under load. But you also have one more feature here that we have launched where you can actually look at the client side and see what was the performance of the engine health. Okay. So these are the load test engines. As you can see here, you have the resource utilization for each of the engines that were generating load. So this really helps customers to make sure that there were the infrastructure that is used to test is not the bottleneck. As you can see, it is well beyond, below 10%, 12% is maximum, right? So it makes sure that the infrastructure is not a bottleneck. And because a high resource utilization can really affect your test results negatively. So this helps them gain confidence.
Absolutely. I've experienced that so many times where my infrastructure bottlenecked while I was running the test, and the bottleneck was the testing module, right? So this is really good to have that feedback, because we can say that obviously the test engines weren't our issue of bottleneck.
Yeah. It also allows you to use these as a way to calibrate your JMeter script. So when you're setting the number of threads in your JMeter script, you can make sure that it is in a healthy range of the load engine health metrics so that you're not overloading the engine. So that helps you calibrate the number of threads as well.
Awesome. That's really insightful. I love how simple it is to get started with Azure Load Testing. And actually, I love the full configuration of it. Having seen it in preview now in GA, it's a lot more easier to configure. There's a lot more options available. It looks really, really solid. It's a really exciting product.
Yeah, looking forward for all customers to use it and give us feedback and help us improve it. And hopefully it helps them also test their application and get better performance from their applications.
Absolutely. So for everyone watching, feedback is crucial. Nikita and her team are watching. They know when you make a feature request or have an issue, they're paying attention to that, and they can prioritize when you have maybe a lot of requests come in for the same requirement or issue. They will absolutely prioritize that. So we'll put the links for the product group, how you can open up an issue or see the features and the roadmaps of Azure Load Testing. And I think, is there anything else, Nikita?
Looking forward to all the feedback.
Awesome. Thank you, everyone, for joining the DevOps Lab, and we'll see you next time.